guys, and today we're gonna visit Kostroma again, because it's worth it. It's second our video, and of course we will visit museum. This is a building of museum, local military museum, small museum. And what we see? First of all, we see that before mud flood we had something really connected with the military, because we see this military robot of our pre-flood civilization. We see fascists, we see swords and so on. But more important here, we see the same picture, the same guy. I think it's a robot. I'm not oversimplifying, I'm not speculating, because we see the same picture, the same guy is everywhere in the world, especially in arches, so-called arches like Notre Dame de, in Paris, near Notre Dame, you know, Arch de Triomphe. And I have seen the same pictures, the same guy in St. Petersburg, in Moscow, in arches and so on. Again, the same guy with fascists inside instead of spine and so on. We see angels here, we see some kind of military scene, I mean picture, and angels with shields, with swords and everything. I will try to show you, but they decorated it so badly. I think they did it purposely to hide all necessary, very important details from us. But we are curious and we will find out anyway. We will find the truth. So let's see. Let's spend some time for searching for details. Because details sometimes is the key to understand everything. For example, this anchor. Or anchor, whatever. It's not a navy anchor. Anchor point. I have no idea what for is it here. For what purpose? And we see angels. Angels were kind of military troops in the past, I think, because they always with swords and everything. They are like protecting people always in all pictures and everything, all depictions. And just see for yourself, what can you see? I need your comments. And I will post the best comments, and then we will exchange our opinions. And of course illumination, because all this were making lights and so on. But let's get inside. Here it says that enemy will be defeated. We are doing right thing. And God is with us. It's our slogan was during the World War II. And let's climb up. And we see strange fence and strange lamps. Of course nothing strange, but you understand my humor. And the most interesting stuff is coming. We see strange devices like cannons. And of course cannonballs are bigger than cannon. The radius, diameter of cannon. What we see is the same stuff in the end. The same ball, but it's not ball. I don't know even how to say it in English. But you understand what I mean. And today I will present you a little bit new information, technical information about cannons in the past, in our free energy past. And this is also strange books, because they're printed modern way, absolutely modern way, but they're 150 years old. And there is no difference between modern and this book. And what is more interesting, I found many gravures and depictions of toroids using in 19th century. Not very often, but there are some, and I will give you links in description below. It's how cannon worked before invasion. That was our weapons, direct energy weapons. Cannons were using energy and toroids, and cannonballs made of not metal, not metallic. And even in the end of 19th century, we see some depictions with toroids, because we were using it. And one engineer also talking about it, he was talking about waveguides in our past and modern because only size difference. That's it. We were using the same waveguides, and this is a satellite dish antenna, and this is the main part, waveguide inside the this dish satellite, and that's it. The satellite antenna, and this is inductor, radiator, emitter in this antenna. And there is no actually different, not much difference between what we have today and we had in the past. Look, it's also emitter. It's also horn antenna with the same emitter like in modern satellite dish. Only size is different. That's it. Nothing else. And we see this device hanged just to keep vibration, to make it vibrate freely without any, I don't know, tight, not tight, free. It must vibrate free and it will make energy. And there are some power generators of nowadays using the same principles. One very small crystal making vibrations and makes energy. And in all depictions we see the same. The same line of cannons. They're using like horn antenna. They had flat surfaces in the end. And white ends. And we see what we see here. Horn antenna and waveguides in modern equipment. And what we see? We see this device with traces of welding. Guess what is it? In the same museum I'm making pictures. It's kind of quad. Short. Metallic short. But with welding. They say it's 16th century. Come on guys, I'm not buying this bullshit. Again Canon, but a really small one. But the same design. Also Canon, but it's also very good weapon. And what is inside? I didn't see any lines inside. It's really not smooth. Not polished, absolutely. It doesn't matter if it's waveguide, but if it's something for gunpowder, it's a disaster. You cannot shoot if it has some not flat surface. And also another cannon, small one, they say it's for small boats. Come on guys. But when I make some noise in one part, it makes perfect noise, it resonates in the end. I will try to add some sound later and you will hear. It's really small. Really small one. But it's real, actual, original weapons. And this is also very nice and interesting. Because it cannot defend the head from anything. But it will defend from energies. All this hair, horse hair, just to collect energy and, ground it. And this all was designed to protect from energy weapons. And you will see what I mean. This gun, this two hands, it's like isolation. Some coils with isolation and those balls in the end. It was for energies to connect some wires. This also has grounding and everything. Connection to the source, to the battery. This is also coils around it to protect hand. And this also to keep the charge. And this was connected to the source of energy like cannons. And as you will see, this all for electrical charges, for electrical damaging person. And this also not for gunpowder. It was gun, not for gunpowder. It's also must be wide open end, because it works, acts like waveguide, like horn antenna. Horn antenna also must have open end, wide open end. And they say it's in Paris. This depiction of Paris. It's also have strange backpack during the battle, because backpack had battery. And this also wires everywhere. It's original weapons, swords, but it has this strange device. And I will show you wires later. And strange depictions, I will show you more depictions. And it also has symbol of our victory. We were defeating snakes, dragons, our enemy. Because this is about 2000 years war, and we lost. This is the wires to connect one source of energy to the weapons. Axial band, we call it. We can see it in admiral, in officers, in navy, in troops, and so on. It is also to keep the charge. We had free energy weapons mostly, not physical damaging people. That's why we had these knights and so on. Again, also wires and coils around this hand. And this also to protect from energy fields, to protect shoulders, coils. Maybe it sounds ridiculous, but it makes some sense if you think about it. It's coils, guys. Really. No plastic, but there is some isolation and so on. It says end of 19th century. Also, just to keep the charge plated and this thing. It's not for decoration, it has some purpose. It's like antenna. And this also to protect from the hand, from the fields, energy fields. And it has also connections, contacts, and wires and so on. And it's all gold plated or bronze plated. It also has coils. Really. I will give you link. Again, wires to connect the source of energy to the weapon. All military of 19th century had it. We can see it in many museums, in many places, and many depictions. This is wire to connect two sources. Actually, the weapon and the source of weapon. Backpack, for example, if it's infantry. Or the source of cap of energy, mercury, cap with mercury, captain. Tin is a mix of mercury and tin and zinc. It called cap. And captain, Tain was in caps. Captain, who was keeping this secret ingredient. It's also, look, when you shoot something, it hits you back. And they claim that this is from Syria, this head. Strange casque. I'm not buying this shit. It's like Peruvian, like inks. But we're in Kostroma, I remind, in center of Russia. I don't know, 1,000 kilometers to any sea. And what else do we see here? Let's talk about it. We can see this also widespread, like antenna, like horn antenna. If it's for shooting with gunpowder, it's useless, absolutely. You cannot point at right place. But if you shoot with toroids, like I showed you in my video about cannons, how it worked. If you shoot it with energy, it makes sense. It must be open wide because it works like waveguide and horn antenna in the end. It's a mix of waveguide and horn antenna. And in the beginning, we have some like piezo effect, something with piezo effect just to start, to initiate it. And if it's connected to the source of energy in the backpack, for example, it will work. It will start like this one. It's like piezo element. We have lighter with this piezo effect. This balls, forget about it. It was added later. It's not needed. We were shooting without any bullets. And I have researched this subject, really, this issue. And it makes sense, really. I have a lot of pictures, depiction, photos of real weapons using different principles. Like here below, you see guns not designed for, you know, when you shoot, you are pushed back. An angle must be 70 or 90. Here we see angle 30 degrees. I mean, when you hold it, I don't know, angle between what you hand, like this one, also not for gunpowder. And this one also not for gunpowder, because different design. Try to understand what I mean. Here, this is for gunpowder, definitely. Because the angle between what you hold and you shoot, I don't know how to, this pipe shooting, this is also mortar, martira we call it. It was really dangerous weapon, but now if we see, I doubt you can shoot anyone using gunpowder with this. But if you use it right way, it can destroy the multi-story block of lead. Or big house from one shot. Yes, exactly. It's a huge waveguide. Big one. That's it. Just bigger. And this one also. If we look inside, we have one smaller diameter and one bigger. One to initiate steroids and second to increase. And this remind me also something. I will try to show you. Just a second. And it reminded me later of Iakov because of its shape. Something like this one, when energy coming from the source. And the same principle like in cannons. You initiate and it goes in between. Energy starts from the beginning, then becomes bigger and goes out. Please read the description I will show you. They say it's from Syria. It's for sacrificing something. Come on. Bullshit. And this is also strange. It's coated with some metals. It's not steel. This one for energy, definitely. Flamberg, like all Flamberg, like it's waveguides. Because of strange shape. Think about it. Why it has those teeth, I would say. And this also, strange cap. Why it has such antenna on top? If you talk about energy weapons, it makes sense. This one also has coils around Hank. Look. It's definitely coils. It's not leather coated. And here we see not energy weapons. Modern one. It's definitely to cut somebody. No connection to energy. But this one, with coils and everything, with grounded, this is for energy. It's the only one I found here in this wall. All the rest normal swords. But if we see this, if we see something like this, it's for energy. This one also for energy.
to protect your hand. This is normal. And you see the difference. And this one with this stuff. This also for energy. Coils. Guys, look. It has coils. Definitely coils. And this for connecting axial band with to the source of energy. To put it inside. This is also for energy. Look, double layers. This guard, we call it garda. And this is contact. And this is also for energy. This is my favorite, I guess. With this ball in the end, definitely. If you see the ball in the end and coils, it's for free energy. And it's all coiled, covered, coated with some metals like gold or bronze. How they did it 200 years ago without electricity? Look, it's like horn antennas, has open wide and widely open end. It also has ball in the end, so it's also for free energy and for designed for no pushing back when you shoot. And it also has coils. I think it's time to wake up, guys, and think about our past. The whole history is a fake. Thank you. Bye. Enough for today.